Well, folks, I've got to take a little side trip from the fan and car projects because my parents' microwave oven stopped working. So we're going to troubleshoot this and see what's wrong with it, see if it can be fixed. Now, the symptom, I've got this on AC current on the line cord, and it's got an offset in it. Let me try to zero that out. Now, I have a bottle of water in the microwave, and Mom tried to heat something this morning and said it didn't get hot. So something's wrong with the actual cooking part of it. I'm going to clear that because it was... And I'm going to push the start, minute plus start, and you should see... It should pull, 1,000 watts or so of power. So we'll start it up. And we're pulling only pulling three amps. So needless to say, 3 amps is not enough power for this microwave. It should do a lot more than that. That makes me think that some component in there is open circuit. So we'll do some investigation and try to figure out what's going on. Now with the microwave oven, the early ones like this are very simple, but there's one thing I've got to say about the working on these. This transformer is very dangerous. It puts out about 2,000 volts. With plenty enough current to kill you. And it will not just kill you, it'll kill you with extreme prejudice and then wait on the next guy to come and kill him too. So whatever you do, if you're not extremely familiar with electrical safety, do not work on these. Now, I have already discharged the capacitor and I have this disconnected so there's no power. And I'm gonna go in there with this meter probe and point some things out, but this meter is not rated for the voltage of this, so I will not be testing here with it on. But for this microwave to work, there's really only 4 things that have to function. The first is the transformer. And the second is the capacitor and the diode. A little black box. And these two work together to make a halfway voltage doubler. And then about 4 kilovolts goes to this magnetron tube. And this is what actually converts the electric power into microwave energy to warm up your food. If the transformer, the capacitor, the diode, and the magnetron are good, you can heat food. All the rest of this stuff in here is merely just so you have a nice fancy display. You could take all that out and replace it with a big chrome toggle switch and have just as good of a microwave. So I'm going to start with basic troubleshooting and see what I can find. Now, as I said, I'm not going to continue to talk about safety, but I'm just going to demonstrate. This has been powered off for quite a while, and I have a jumper lead that's connected to ground here, and I'm going to touch it on every point that has been part of that high voltage circuit. Now, that way I'm sure this capacitor is discharged, and I do have the line cord disconnected, so there's no way it's going to turn on while I'm working on it. I'm going to go back to the tripod and do some component tests now. Make sure I'm on screen. Okay, the first thing I'm going to test, which is relatively easy, is to make sure that the transformer winding is not open. Normally a transformer will short circuit and start blowing fuses before it goes open, so I really don't believe that's going to be the problem. In this transformer, the secondary, the high voltage winding, it is connected through from this output terminal to ground. So I'm going to measure from ground to the transformer output tab. And I've got a complete circuit, 150 ohms. And that makes sense because that is a high voltage winding, many, many turns of very small wire. Now, the magnetron tube, it's an electron tube. So it has a heated filament inside it. You can't see it, but it's in there. And that should have a low resistance circuit. And in here, where the two leads from the transformer filament winding go on, I'll take one side off so that I have just the magnetron to test. And I'll test like so. I've got a closed circuit. That's good. It is a very low resistance circuit. So next that leaves the capacitor and diode. So I'm going to cut off the video and I'm going to take that out of there where I can get to it. Save you guys watching me fumble in there with the big hands in a small place. Got this out now. 0.8 microfarad, 2000 volts, no PCBs. Uh-oh, that's the problem. They left out a part. They put the PCBs in there, it would still be working. No, just kidding. So we can test that with the meter. I'll put it on capacitance test mode. You can see that. And I'll check the capacitor like so. 0.807 microfarad, so that capacitor is perfectly good. I'm going to check to the can and make sure there's no shorts. Nope. So we have the diode now. The diode is a trick though. Because it's a high voltage diode, you can't use the Fluke meter's diode test function. So I'm going to use a battery and a light. The reason for that is the forward voltage of that diode, so it's probably actually many diode junctions in series in there to withstand the high voltage. So the forward voltage is more than that meter can put out. So got the little light. Oh, you can't see that. I'm doing a terrible job with this video, I realize that, but I'm just trying to get it done quickly because I want to get this checked out and be done with it. So got a test light. Where it's working. I check the diode this way. I get some current flow. Check it the other way, it's blocking. So that tells me the diode itself is working. And I happen to have a spare just to compare the action of the diode. That way, no current flow. This way, some current flow. You notice it's a low current, but once again, these are designed to operate at a very high voltage. So we'll go from here to there. Passes current. Turn it the other way. Nothing. So that tells me I've narrowed it down to one part that's not working, and that would be the magnetron. So I've got this one here. I don't know where it came from or if it's good or not. So I'm just going to put it in there and see if it works. Well, I took the old magnetron out and I found on this connector there was a little bubbled up charge spot. So out of curiosity, I cut that out with a Dremel and it looks like there's a capacitor made into that connector. I don't know what, it's probably a filter to keep RF energy from going back this way. You got these two chokes and then that deal. So there was a visible sign of burning, so that backs up my observation with the testing the other components. Now, the one that I have here is electrically compatible, but it doesn't have these mounting holes in it. And I'm sorry I didn't video this, but I took the grinder and I cut off the tabs on the side of it. And I'm going to go, and I marked it. I put it in there and marked it. I'm going to go over to the drill press and drill some holes there so it'll mount. And then we'll put it in there and see if we've managed to save this microwave or if I'm going to have to try to hunt down a new old stock magnetron. All right, maybe it'll work now. Go clean this up a little bit and we'll put it in. Okay, got my scrap bin magnetron put in there with its modified mounting. And the actual cables come in from a different angle, but that's gonna be fine. I've got everything positioned where it's not close to anything to arc to. So, remember last time it was pulling about 3 amps because it wasn't doing anything. And now we'll turn it on here, and I do have a bottle of water inside. So let's see what kind of current draw we get now. It should pull 1.2 kilowatts according to the nameplate. So right at 10 amps, 10.1. volts times 10 amps, that's right at 1.2 kilowatts, so that's perfect. I put that tape on there to direct the air from the fan so since the shell is not on. Make sure the air goes through the magnetron to cool it. So that looks like it's working properly. Now, one reason that I consider this oven worth fixing, it belongs to my parents, so it's worth fixing no matter what to me. But if you look at this back here, you notice assembled in USA. Not going to find that anymore. And if you look at the transformer, Advanced Transformer Company, that's made USA. If you look at the fan motor, that's also made in USA. The micro switches, there's a lot of US content in this oven, and it's a Sharp brand, which that's a Japanese brand, which I have no problem with, made in 1988. And as you saw earlier, the troubleshooting was very, very simple. Narrowed down to the bad part right away and dug around in the scrap bin and had what we needed. So easy to fix. No inverter board, no high-tech wizardry in there that's going to do anything crazy. Just very straightforward. So now just get the cover back on it and get it back to my parents' place. And of course, you know the old function test is always to put a fluorescent tube in there and see what happens. I don't have the turntable. That's why I've got it sitting on that block of wood. So if the microwave works, that fluorescent tube ought to light up. As you can see, there's plenty of light off the tube in there. If you think that there's something wrong and it's drawing a lot of current and you don't want to burn anything out, you don't want to wait to try to heat up any food or water to see if it's working, you can put this in there and you know in an instant if it's putting out microwave or not. Another good thing about a lot of earlier appliances, this oven has it, there's a schematic on the inside of the cover to help you with troubleshooting and just understanding how it's supposed to work. And you can tell how simple it is by looking at that. So got the cover back on, took my steaming hot bottle of water out of there that I'm not going to drink like that. Going to get this thing taken back to Mom and Dad's house before long, probably tomorrow morning. Only trouble we've had until this happened was this little drive coupling here had broken before. And ordered a package of 3 or 4 of them, or 4 or 5 I think. Still have 2 left. So got some spares for that. And digging around in my junk, I found I actually have even more magnetrons. So hopefully that doesn't happen again anytime soon. But if it does, I'm prepared. So I hope y'all found this educational and enjoyed watching it. And keep the good old stuff working. And don't be part of the throwaway society that's been such a problem in America lately. You can't get anything built quite like they used to build it. It's all throwaway junk now. Not repairable, not sustainable. You got something from the good old days, try to keep it that way. Catch you later.